Hello everyone. Hi all. Thank you so much for joining. Yeah. So my name is Meghna Adhikari and I'm a campaign coordinator at FIAPO. I'm your host today. My major work at FIAPO includes supporting and mentoring grassroots community to be vocal for animal rights. So as you all know, festival season has begun. Every month we will be having number of occasions, and I'm sure all of you all will be mostly spending your time with family, and even otherwise it's like a happy occasion for all of us. So on that note, we thought that let's just come up with this unique session wherein we can help you reset your closet with a more of a ethical, mindful, sustainable touch to it. So that's why here we are. And today's webinar is organized by FIAPO. I would like to share a little bit about FIAPO. Federation of Indian Animal Protection Organization is India's apex animal rights agency. FIAPO is the catalyst that protects the interests of animals on local and national level through education, research, mobilization, training, and direct action. It has 165 members and over 200 supporter organizations across the country. We facilitate grassroots networking, leadership development with various campaigns in city, state, and national level with activists and animal protection organizations. So today, for this webinar, we have a wonderful speaker with us who hails from a beautiful city, Mangalore, the coastal belt. And I would like to introduce a little bit about Dr. Shruti Rao. Dr. Shruti Rao is a dentist by profession, animal rights activist, environmentally conscious, and zero waste enthusiast. Along with her profession, she devotes her time to taking care of street animals, rescuing, and also indulges herself in environment upliftment projects. She's passionate about art and owns her own home-based business of handmade products and accessories by the name Soulfully Made Crafts. Dr. Shruti is setting herself an example for all of us by leading an ethical, sustainable, environment-friendly life. We are so, so glad to have you, Dr. Shruti. And it's over to you now.
Hi, Meghna. First of all, thank you for such a lovely introduction. And thanks to FIAPO and to you mainly for giving me this opportunity and considering me, you know, worth it to come and speak here about something that's very close to my heart. And and welcome to everybody and hi to everybody. Looking forward to, you know, have a wonderful, interesting, fun as well as, you know, informative session, because this is going to be fun because the topic itself is, you know, has so many pros and cons to it, like the leaving itself, but it's fun because we are going to try to make the best out of that particular leaving. So I'm super excited to share my journey and share some, you know, great insights as to how, you know, we all can be a little bit more caring about this environment. So I guess we begin now, Meghna.
Yes, Shruti, we are all excited.
Okay, please. Same here, yes. Hi guys, today we'll be speaking something very, very interesting. I guess most of you all who have joined here are into this particular lifestyle where you want to bring about a better change not only to yourself but your fellow beings as well as this earth. Make a change to reduce your carbon footprint on this earth. It can be a small step just by changing what's on your plate, or it can be, you know, steps like what you wear, what you are buying, how you're living. So all this is a way of, you know, lifestyle wherein you show that to people that you care not only about yourself but about others. So welcome you all to the topic Closet Reset, which is the ethical fashion and sustainable living. I am Dr. Shruti Rao. As Meghan has said, I'm a vegan activist and a sustainability consultant. More than being recognized as a dentist, I always like to call myself as an animal activist because that is much more closer to my heart. I'm also a founder of a sustainable home-based art business called Soulfully Made Crafts. So it's basically fiber art, which deals with complete eco-friendly, plastic-free and natural fibers that is derived from cotton. And I make home decors and personal accessories from this brand. So to begin with, when we say sustainability, I'm sure we all use this word sustainability, not only when it comes to environmental aspect, we might even say that, okay, this particular thing is how it's going to sustain. So we know, I'm sure most of us know what sustainability means. So sustainability is basically a way via which we can maintain, okay? So via which we can maintain. So via this lifestyle, we are trying, via this lifestyle, we are now trying to make a change and improve the lifestyle of the environment, the planet, as well as various other resources that is surrounding us. So sustainability basically is the ability to maintain at a certain rate or level and is the avoidance of the depletion of natural resources in order to maintain an ecological balance. Sustainable living describes a lifestyle that attempts to reduce an individual's or society's use of Earth's natural resources and one's personal resources. So basically, the definition says that it is about maintaining a lifestyle in which you care about the environment, about how the resources that you are using is affecting the environment as well as the economy of this particular world. So there are three pillars of sustainability. That is basically, it involves a particular harmony between three major aspects of the society of this particular living, that is the planet. Obviously, we are concerned about the planet, about the resources we are consuming from this planet, about the people, the society that we are living in, what we are offering to the society if you are a brand, or what a particular brand is offering to us. So basically the society, and how this is helping the economy, how is it helping the growth of this particular economy, how is it causing us a profit. So these are the three pillars of sustainability. When there is a coexistence between these three pillars, that is when, you know, a sustainable living is success. So when I say that, it's very important to know that when you're trying to lead a sustainable lifestyle, it should also be economical. It should also be profitable. At the same time, it should also help the people. So there should be a proper coexistence, interdependence between these three factors. Only then a sustainable living can actually help in maintaining a good, in helping us to maintain the resources of this particular earth. So there are three main types of economy system that, you know, the whole of this world runs by. So it's called as a linear economy, then there is a reuse economy and the circular economy. So linear economy is something that most of us follow. Okay, it's like we buy a product, you know, that product is made for us, we just use it and then we don't think when disposing it. So that's what most of us do. That is, we buy a product, we use it, and then we just dispose it. So this is what happens to most of the products that we are using, most of the things that we buy. That is, we aimlessly, without any particular interest as to how it is happening, what it is happening, we just dispose it. So this is one particular economy that is a curse to the planet, that is a curse to our health, and that's also a curse to the future generation, because we are depleting the So next, moving on to reuse economy. So what is reuse economy basically? So reuse economy basically means reusing something that we have already bought. So the production is the same, the use of resources is the same. And once we buy that particular product, we are making something out of it once we have used for which particular purpose it was first created. For example, we see a lot of plastic bottles being upcycled. We see a lot of glass bottles being upcycled. We see certain furnitures being upcycled, remodeled. So that is reuse economy, and in such a way that we make use of it and finally we use that particular product to recycle and create something else. So we have to keep it in mind that we see a lot of companies that are now saying that we are plastic positive in nature. That means that they're recycling this particular plastic again and again to produce their products. But you have to keep in mind that once a plastic has reached a particular time of recycling, they can't be recycled again. After a particular time, the plastic loses its characteristics via which it can become stirred, and as a result, you can't reuse it again. So finally, plastic has to go as a waste because you can't make a lot out of it after it's been recycled again and again. The last type of economy that we are all stressing about is something called as a circular economy, which is the need of the moment. So basically, it means that you're using resources, those resources that are available on this earth, which can later be reused again, which can go back to the earth again, and you can use it without harming the earth. So basically, you're seeing new lot of products from bamboo, lot of products that are coming from hemp. So these are those particular resources that can be reused, recycled, given back to the earth, again used to produce some product, then used by the, you know, society, and then it can be given back to the earth. That is the resources. That is the circular economy, and that is what we want to stress. We don't want a particular product to go to a waste. We don't want a particular product to go and end up in a landfill, which is actually the doom of the current situation. So we don't want that to happen. So keeping that in mind, how can you start your journey towards circular economy? You don't have to be perfect. You don't have to be the best. You don't have to do everything that makes your living sustainable. It's about the small steps that actually matter, and it's about many people doing many similar steps which are sustainable in nature that later helps our earth. So I can myself be a zero waste, I can be a vegan, I can, you know, be like, you know, minimalist, but if I'm doing it all alone, how is it actually helping the earth in the long run, or the whole picture? It's I'm working alone. Yes, it matters a person to do it alone, but you should not forget that it should be a movement. It should be a movement where many people join and many people do make an attempt to change how they are living and work towards a better lifestyle. So as an individual, there are many small steps one can do. So it might be daunting for you to think that how, as an individual, like, what should I do now? Should I stop using plastic? Okay, should I stop eating everything? Should I just eat that comes without plastics, or that comes without packaging? No, it's not basically about that. It's even the small steps that do matter in the long run. So basically, you need to stop only taking from the earth and not giving it back. So basically, we are giving pollution, okay, back to the earth, and we're not giving anything else. So basically, what we need to do is we need to take or make from this particular earth, use it to the full, then make ways to reuse it again. And then once it's used to its best, we need to remake it again and then send it to recycle, so that that particular product is used again once recycled to be made into another product. So example is bamboo. Let's take example of bamboo, which is being used in a lot of products these days, and it's very simple. Obviously, bamboo, once used, you dispose it. It goes back to the earth. It becomes it gets degraded in the earth after a particular time, and then you're not polluting the earth. Basically, it's that particular concept that you make a cycle out of it and you just don't, you know, dispose it and trash it. So that's the basic concept of sustainability, and that's how you can start the small step. You can start your sustainable lifestyle either by being a vegan. You can start your sustainable lifestyle by starting your low waste journey and then being a zero waste. You can start your sustainable lifestyle by being conscious about what you're buying, how you're buying, where you're buying it, from whom you're buying it. And you can be a sustainable, you can start your sustainable lifestyle by being a minimalist. So when I say minimalist, it doesn't mean that you're buying or owning only 10 things, like 10 books, 10 clothes, you know, not that. It's basically using the products only that you need. We all have a tendency to just hoard things. We have a tendency to just clutter. And I'm sure all of us, at one point of our time, we have cluttered a lot of things or still do, you know. So basically, it's being conscious about what you need and keeping only that, buying only that when you're done using the product that you already have to its fullest. So you can be any one of this, or you can be all of this. You can be a vegan and buy only products that are sold without plastics, and you're trying to reduce your plastic use, plastic consumption. You can be conscious when you're buying only what you need, and you're also thinking about from whom you're buying. If you're buying from local, you are being sustainable. If you're buying package free, you're being sustainable again. If your product is being made in your own area, in your own state, you're being sustainable again. Because if there is a product A, which is made in your state as well as your neighboring state, you should always think that the product A that is made in your state is more sustainable than the product that is made in your neighboring state. Because the product, if it has to come from your neighboring state, it has to travel few extra miles. So again, you are not being that sustainable. But if you're using it from your own state, from your own district, from your own area, you are being more and more sustainable. So this is the small steps that you can do just by sitting at your home, being conscious when you are buying a particular product, when you're ordering a particular product. So that's how you can start just sitting at your home, just start, you know, an easy journey towards sustainability. So here I have just put few pictures via which one can be sustainable. You can walk to the grocery store or, you know, shop instead of taking your car. You can say no to plastics whenever possible. You can buy bulk producers if you have, you know, the bulk shops. I'm sure most of the cities have bulk shops where you get grains and pulses in bulk, and you they just weigh and give it to you as much as you want, not the pre-packed ones. So you can carry your own produce bags, you can carry already existing plastic in your home, or you can even carry dabbas, boxes to that particular shop and ask them to refill for you whenever you need them. So these are the small steps. Composting in your house, using shampoo bars instead of the shampoo bottles, using bamboo products like bamboo toothbrush, then bamboo cutleries instead of the plastic ones, recycling your products, eating more of a plant-based diet, using bucket bath instead of the shower bath. All these actually matter to, you know, lead a sustainable life. This is the simplest way via which you can start your sustainable journey. So from your kitchen to what you use in, you know, your daily activities, for your self-care, to your home products, as well as the products that you might use when you're outside your home, all have a sustainable swap, all have a sustainable alternative. So, you know, as I said, bulk shopping, buying package-free products, using, you know, dabbas or boxes while you go to takeaways instead of getting their, paper bags or their aluminium packaging, foil packaging products, using, you know, tea infusers instead of tea bags, using cloth napkins instead of paper towels or paper napkins. All these do matter, and all these are the smallest steps, but which make a huge difference in the long run when you start your sustainable lifestyle. On the go, for example, if you're going somewhere and you want to reduce your carbon footprint, reduce your plastic intake, the best thing that you can do is carry a metal straw if you know that you're going to end up drinking maybe a tender coconut or a juice. So avoid the straw, and if you're okay drinking without the straw, great. But if you need a straw, it's better to keep a metal straw in your bag, so that, because you know yourself, most of us know what our routine is, how our tendency is to buy something, so we can, you know, learn from ourselves, from our own lifestyle, and try to change it into a better. Carrying your own bottle, carrying, you know, some snacks instead of buying those 5 rupees, 10 rupees plastic packed snacks. Because at the end, those plastic, you know, for example, I'll not name a company, but the chips that comes usually, the 10 rupees one, the 20 rupees one, if you see the inside lining, is inside layer is silver in color. Such plastics are not at all recyclable. You can't do anything with such plastic, and they directly end up in the landfill. Instead of that, the best thing you can do is carry maybe some nuts, some fruits, you know, or some cookies which are homemade or, you know, locally made, and you're going to reduce your plastic consumption. So these are the small steps that you can take in order to live a very sustainable life. Here I have given you an example of how you can change your lifestyle just by, you know, making certain changes and you are opting for certain other alternatives. So you can see here I've given option of reusable and the toxic plastic options. So using a cloth bag, using, you know, the paper pencils that come, the plantable pencils, using metallic scales instead of the plastic scales, using steel straw instead or the steel spoons and forks instead of the plastic spoons and fork, using your own bottle, using your own cup when you're going. Also an important thing, all the females, even males, it's very important to know that sanitary pad that we use take 800 years to decompose, guys. One sanitary pad takes 800 years to decompose. So the sanitary pad maybe I use for the first time is still somewhere lying on this earth, and you know, it's going to stay longer than me. I might die after a few years. It's going to be there for, you know, another 800 to 1000 years, haunting us, haunting our mother earth. And you can make a change by, you know, opting for cloth pads which are really, you know, hygiene. We might feel a little gross while you think about cloth pads, but trust me, I've been using it since the last 2.5 years, and they are great. Once you get to know how to use it, they are really great, and you are saving so much money, because this cloth pad can be used for a period of 4 to 5 years without, you know, they don't lose their characteristics, and they work really fine for a period of 4 to 5 years. So it's one time investment, and you don't have to spend again and again what you usually do on these sanitary pads. Even using menstrual cups is a great option, because you are making a sustainable choice. So these are the small steps that you can take towards sustainability. Also, this is another same picture, but you know in which I have zoomed and just put the sustainable swap. So you can use all these products and you can reduce your carbon footprint. Stationery items like jute folders instead of those plastic folder, paper or cardboard files instead of those plastic files, paper jute pouches or cloth pouches, metallic scale, all these matter a lot, because these pens, we all, I guess, have used a lot of 3 rupees pens which are single use, and we just toss it without thinking, right? We just throw it without thinking, and mind you, those are not even recycled. So they are all somewhere on this earth, you know, haunting us forever. So these are the small steps that you can take, which do matter a lot. So this is what I carry personally in my bag wherever I go, because I know that when I see a tender coconut, stall, I tend to go and drink tender coconut. So I keep a metal straw with me always. I like eating, you know, Golgappa, so I usually carry my own dabba, because I don't want to use, the plastic cups or even the arecanut cups, because again, mind you, that is single use. That arecanut cup is single use and it goes to trash. Yes, it is getting decomposed, but it's single use. Single use trash is again not sustainable, even though it is plastic free. So these do matter. I carry my own bottles, I carry my own bags. I also have market as 7. These are my own produce bags. These are made out of cotton dhotis, which usually the men in our household use. I've just stitched it into, you know, square pouches, and that's how I get my groceries. I just separate, you know, like corianders and chilies, which might get squished and squashed with other vegetables. I separately segregate them, put them in these particular produce bag, and then carry it in my own bag and get it home. That way I don't need a separate plastic or paper being wrapped for my coriander, because we usually do that. When we buy coriander leaves, they wrap it in a paper newspaper and give it to us, and we just throw that newspaper back into the dustbin, right? So to avoid that, I carry my own produce bags. So this is again when it comes to self-care, various products which we'll be covering in detail, how you can, you know, make the swap. Here is an oral health which you can use, which is completely zero waste and sustainable, except for that particular toothpaste that I still use, because I have bought a lot of them and I'm using them to its best. So basically, again, sustainability is about not buying. So what do I mean when I say not buying? You might see a particular product in the market that says, okay, it is sustainable. So that doesn't mean that you just have to buy it. The same product which is not made out of a sustainable material, that is made out of plastic, might be available in your home, but it functions just as good as that particular sustainable alternative. Use that product that is already existing in your home. Once you are done using it, only then buy the next sustainable alternative. So that is very important, you guys. The best sustainable choice you can make is not making one. That means not buying products just because you want to buy, or just because it is, you know, zero waste, or it is sustainable, or it is, you know, eco-friendly. I'm sure most of us have certain products in our home that is lying around waiting for us to be, you know, so that we can use it. But then we just keep it aside because we think that, oh, it's in a plastic packaging. Instead of that, I'll buy something that is coming in a bamboo packaging. Don't do that. Just look around your home. Just declutter your home. I'm sure you'll find some products that are lying in your home which you haven't used in a while. Use that to its best and then make the sustainable buy. So again, these are how you can have a sustainable shower routine, where I'm using a loofah that is made from a natural, vegetable based coir. Then we have, you know, package free shampoos, bamboo razors, pumice stones for scrubs, handmade scrubs. You know, these all matter, which can lead into a sustainable living. So now, obviously, we discussed, we can see here two products. One is a plastic toothbrush, one is a bamboo toothbrush. Obviously, if I ask you guys now which is more sustainable, you will tell me it's the bamboo toothbrush. Yes, bamboo toothbrush is more sustainable. But here you have two sustainable options, that is a bamboo straw and a steel straw. Now, if I ask you which is more sustainable, for me, the steel straw is more sustainable. Why? Because steel straw can be used for a longer period of time than the bamboo straw. You have to remember that the bamboo is a material which is basically wood, and after a particular usage, you can't use it again, because bamboo, whenever it comes in contact with moisture, after a while, sometimes, you know, maybe after a few months or a year, it starts getting mold starts growing in it, fungus starts growing in it. You will have to dispose it off. Whereas steel straw, if you clean it properly, it's going to come with you for years together. I'm sure we all use steel utensils in our home that is there since our granny's age, okay? So this steel straw, you can maybe pass it down to your kids also. So single use again, or when it comes to its longevity and lifespan, that also matters when you're making sustainable choices, because steel straw is more sustainable when compared to a bamboo straw. So this is how you can, you know, think, make a research of your own, study about it, and start making alternatives in your life. So now I get a common question is, sustainable living is difficult, sustainable living is expensive, especially girls I get to hear say, who loves clothes. I love clothes. I used to love buying from these big brands, but these big brands, which are called the fast fashion, are not sustainable. These fast fashion have a tendency to large produce, in large quantity for few months, and then they discard it because there's a new trend that is coming after the next 6 months. So if you know top brands, from luxury brands even to high street brands, what you see in malls, every year they burn a lot of garments because they are not sold and they don't want to resell it because it is not fitting into the trend. So when it comes to fashion, when it comes to your accessories, bags, belts, when it comes to your lifestyle, that is, you know, as I said, personal care products, what you use in your day-to-day life, or even your cosmetic products, you can make sustainable swaps. How can you make it? One is by opting for brands that are sustainable, zero waste, vegan, ethical, as well as cruelty free. So if you can afford it, there are so many sustainable markets, there are so many sustainable companies which actually work towards making this earth better for all the living beings. So you can opt for that. If you can't opt for it, opt for these certain sustainable brands which can be expensive, you can opt for second-hand products, you can opt for thrifting items. If you don't want to buy products which somebody has already used, you can borrow from your relatives, your friends, your cousins, and also you can rent products. This way you are not creating unnecessary depletion of resources, because just like a work for you, like after this particular, you know, webinar, just go into your wardrobe, open your wardrobe and see. I'm sure you have a lot of clothes that, okay, now forget about the pandemic. I'm sure we have not moved out, but just think about the 2019 scenario. I'm sure there are at least 10 particular clothing items that you have not worn, which you're just clinging on to thinking that you're going to wear it again. And if you have not, there is a particular theory that says that if you have not worn a particular piece of clothing for 6 months, there is high chances that you won't wear it in the coming years. So that's how you can know, and you can maybe swap it with your friends, you can exchange with your friends, or even resell. There are so many thrifting markets in India, which is really great. So you can resell there and you can make money out of it, which is really great. And also opting for brands that make products by using plastics, by using corks, by using rubber tires, and they make cool products like bags, they make products like sandals, shoes. So opt for products like this. Social media is the biggest boon for us when it comes to this, because there are so many shops available on Instagram as well as Facebook that are sustainable. So how to avoid buying from these fast fashion or non-sustainable brands? That is completely trying to avoid buying, buy only when you need. Otherwise, just don't go to buy because there is a sale, okay, or because you're just passing by and you feel like buying. Don't do that. Buy only what you need. Research before you buy. Just think, are you going to use it? How well are you going to use it? Buy second hand or rent a product or custom make one product, clothing for you from your local tailor. Use eco-friendly fabrics like cotton. The synthetic polyester is not eco-friendly. The nylon is not eco-friendly because they're not going to buy or degrade. Shop from local brands. If you still want to buy new clothes, go to your local brands. There are so many local small boutiques and shops that will sell you products, and it's a great way to support small business. Now we're all speaking about vocal for local and support small businesses. This way it's a great option, to opt for small brands. Choose quality over quantity always. Carry your own bag. Ask for package free product buying when you go to a shop. Like if you're buying a gift and it's buying for your close friends or even for your best friends, see to that you don't wrap it unnecessarily. Anyways, the person is going to tear it open, or even open it and just keep the particular gift wrapping aside. So just, don't unnecessarily pack it if that person is okay. Try communicate with the person and make them understand that, I didn't pack it because it's unnecessary. Wear more often, wash less. Like denim, they say that you should not wash at least for 10 times. Wash it only after you have worn it for 10 times, because you wash it that often, you are making the product lose its quality. And also go to your cupboard, declutter your cupboard, rewear what is there in the cupboard, see some products, see some clothes that might not fit you, that might need an alteration. So repair it, stitch, mend it if necessary, upcycle a particular product. If there's a sari and you're not wearing it, turn it into a kurta, turn it into a dhoti, or turn it into a curtain, turn it into a tablecloth. Options are so many. Still, if you don't want to use it, sell it on marketplaces. And if you don't want to sell it, there are so many people who will be more than happy to take this product, so you can donate it to them. Now moving to beauty without cruelty. So always remember, vegan is not equal to cruelty free, and vegetarian is not equal to cruelty free. If a particular product is cruelty free, that doesn't mean that it is vegan. A particular product has to be vegan. That means it should not have any animal derived products, and also it should not be tested on animals. So these two particular aspects are completely different entity. So a product has to be vegan and it has to be cruelty free for it to be sustainable and for it to fit into the vegan lifestyle. So a product can be only cruelty free, a product can be only vegan, a product can be both vegan and cruelty free, that is what we are aiming at. A product can be non-vegan and not cruelty free, which we don't want to use, we have to avoid. So again, these products can be a sustainable or it can't be sustainable. That means it can have, zero waste packaging, or it can be filled with plastic packaging. So again, there is a choice that you can make. So if you're opting for vegan and cruelty-free brands, opt for those brands that are sustainable or that come with low waste or less waste or complete zero waste packaging. So when it comes to beauty, obviously we say that the inside beauty matters a lot, and beauty without cruelty is what we are aiming at. But ethical beauty is basically which fits all these criteria, that it should be vegan, it should be cruelty free, it should be zero waste or sustainable, as well it should have ethical and fair trade. So ethical trade is separate, fair trade is separate. Ethical trade and fair trade basically means that the people who are involved in creating this particular product should also be respected. Their basic right also has to be followed. All the humanitarian and ethical aspects should be followed. That means they are helping, they are giving them their pay at the right time, they are not discriminating them. Also, ethical fair trade means this particular company is helping those class or those category group of society that are usually discriminated or those that are usually underprivileged. So all these together forms a complete ethical beauty or an ethical product. It doesn't have to be beauty, it can be any product for that matter. So when you're buying any products, it's always good to look for these logos. These logos are certified by various companies. We have PETA logo, we have logo from the Leaping Bunny. Then we also have the logo from the CCF Rabbit, which is a choose cruelty-free organization. So these are the logos that usually indicate us that it is a certified cruelty-free company. So what are the products you need to look for? You also have to remember that certain cruelty-free brands might have vegan products, but they may not be marketing it as vegan. But if you know, if you have already an idea about what are the ingredients that you have to avoid in makeup and beauty products, then you can buy it even though it is not mentioned as vegan. Basically, ghee, milk proteins, honey, propolis, beeswax that is derived from bee, gelatin that is derived from animal bone, skin, fur, lashes, and oil from mink. Then tallow, which is the most common product what you see in your powders, talcum powders, Pond's and Yardley, etc. They all have sodium tallowate in it, which is basically fat from the cow. Then mucin from snails, usually seen in sheep mask. Then squalene from sharks, not commonly available in India, but obviously in Korean and Japanese beauty products, these are found. Lanolin, which is also sheep oil, most commonly seen as a base to hold the beauty product together. Keratin, we hear a lot about it. Keratin is not cruelty-free, it's not vegan, it's derived from the hair and horns of animals. So avoid keratin therapy. Then there is the red color, usually used as a dye to give that particular pigmentation, which is derived from an insect bug. Then there is collagen, again in sheet mask, in, you know, serums, hair serums, face serums, silk proteins, lard fat from pig, musk, which is the most common, you know, fragrance flavor, which is derived from the genital of deers, musk, deer, civet, and beavers. Then stearic acid, which is also an animal fat, and natural hair brushes like horse brushes. Then there is mink. Then there is also buffalo and cow mane brushes that are used for making cosmetic brushes, or even, you know, shaving brushes, or if you are into art, they make, you know, paint brushes out of it. So those are the things you need to avoid. So these are the vegan cosmetic brands in India that are completely vegan. We have Disguise Cosmetics, Specta, Iba Halal, Debashree, which is recently launched, Boss Lady Cosmetics, then is Blur, then FAE, lots of them. Some make really great products, and some even take back their empty, you know, boxes, like, you know, those containers, which is really great. Like Disguise Cosmetics and Boss Lady Cosmetics takes back their tins as well as lipstick, you know, containers once you have used it, because they're going to reuse it, which is really great. And I guess we have to support brands like this, because their step shows that they care about the environment. Then there are 23 brands with vegan options. The list is here, like Ruby's Organic, Sugar Cosmetics, My Glam, NYX, The Body Shop, Makeup Revolution, Australis. And then there are complete cruelty-free brands which don't have a lot of vegan options. And, you know, the list is here. I'm not going to go into too many details, because the cruelty-free brands in India are countless, just that, you know, you can go on speaking about it. These are vegan and cruelty-free skincare, haircare, and toiletry brands in India. I basically love Sentora, which is run by two girls based in Bangalore. They are completely package-free. They don't use any plastic in their packaging. They're all zero waste. They take their tins back once you have used it. And they're really great. They're small business. Then there is Plum Cosmetics, I guess most of the vegans use. Conscious Chemist. Then there is Dr. Safe. Then Sapphire Botanics. Many of them. And I feel really happy when I see that, like, 3 years back, there were not many companies actually coming out as vegan and cruelty. Yeah, cruelty free was there, but they were not coming out as vegan. Now there are so many companies that are stressing, saying that they're vegan, they're sustainable, and they are also cruelty free, which is really great. Then these are other brands that are cruelty free. When it comes to skincare, hair care, they also have vegan options. These are available in India. Don't worry if I'm rushing through this, but I'll give you a name of few people whom you can follow on Instagram, and they have their website of their own. If you want, you can take a screenshot out of it. And these are, great human beings who are striving really hard in the beauty industry to promote vegan and cruelty-free products. There is Logical Harmony, Tashina Coombs. Love her work. You can go follow her. Cruelty-free Kitty, Ethical Bunny, Cruelty-free Marta, Cruelty-free Peter Orb also has the list of products available in India. And our very own, from India, we have the Mystic Trial, who always shows only cruelty-free and vegan products. You can do follow her on Instagram, and you will get the list of all the products that I've mentioned in the previous slides. Now, also when it comes to beauty products, we can think that, you know, there are many household treasures that are, vegan, cruelty-free, as well as zero waste, like basil, turmeric, you know, the basic gram floor acts as a great face wash, like gram floor mixed with turmeric and oats floor, and you can use maybe a tea tree oil or some essential oil and just rub it on your face, wash it with water, works really well as a face wash. Then we have face scrub and body scrub, brown sugar, coffee ground, as well as oats, which is, you know, grinded coarsely with coconut oil, acts as a great scrub. Then we have various list of kitchen ingredients, from papaya, aloe vera, oats, banana, basil, turmeric, tomato, cucumber, and even the expensive avocado. These all can be used as a great face mask, as face care routine, which will really, you know, plump your face and bring the glow back in your face. Cucumber can be used as a toner, just, you know, blend it in the mixer, strain the water, and that water can be used as a great toner. Then hair care, again, we have hibiscus leaves, hibiscus flower, amla, soap nut, rita kai. All this can be used as conditioner as well as shampoo together. Then we have apple cider vinegar, which is a great clarifying shampoo to cleanse your hair and remove all the residue from your hair. Flax seeds and oats act really well as deep conditioner. Just add them in water. Once they swell up, make a paste out of it, apply it in your hair, leave it for 20 minutes and then wash. And they act as real great deep conditioning. Obviously, oils, buying cold pressed, food pressed, package free oil works really great. You don't have to buy, the fancy coconut oil or, fancy hair serum, etc. Our grandparents have much better, hair texture and hair length when compared to us because they use natural oils which were naturally derived, like cold pressed or wood pressed. As I said, for deep hair conditioning, oats, flax seeds and banana work really well. Aloe vera again is one ingredient I love using. I use it in face mask, I use it for my hair, I use it for burns. Like I'm very clumsy, so I keep getting burns when I'm cooking, so I use it for that. Also, when I sleep in the night, I just apply a thin layer of aloe vera, not every day, but most of the time, and it's going to moisturize my face, especially when I have dry skin. So many options that are just there around us that work as really great skincare as well as hair care routine. Now, I'll be touching up a small bit about sustainable business. So, how and why did I start this particular sustainable business called as Soulfully Made Crafts? So, basically, I started this backstory is because I wanted to make another side hustle, another income, so that I can feed a lot of other community dogs, because the community dogs in my area, the numbers were increasing day by day. I was fostering a lot of dogs and kittens, so I wanted to have a side hustle wherein I could actually help these animals in need. So my main interest when it came to sustainability business was to do a particular business that the society will love and will have a positive effect on the people, as well as the business which has a positive impact on the environment also. So I wanted to do this particular business which will help the society, which will help the environment, as well as which will help my pocket, that is the economy, basically, for me, again, the three pillars of sustainability. So when I wanted to start, I thought of the few aspects that would make my business more sustainable. So I wanted to use only environmental friendly products, which are obviously plant derived. So all of my products are made from cotton. I use scrap fabrics, like leftover textile waste, to make products like earring pouches. All my packaging is plastic free. Even I don't use cello tape, I either use paper tape. I also see to it that less waste is created, and I come up with cool ideas with all the leftover fabric scrap or cotton scrap by making some product out of it. I always try to reuse and repurpose. Like as I said, I take products from textiles, like from tailors, which are cotton, and I reuse them and upcycle them to make good useful products. My sustainable business, I aim at having a minimal carbon footprint. When I say this, what I basically mean is I'm not promoting anything here, but I opt for Indian Post service over other delivery services, because other delivery service, yes, they promise quick delivery, they deliver within 1 or 2 days. So the carbon footprint here is a little bit more because they use either air or for longer distance. So to avoid that, I usually use Indian Post, because even to most of the areas, they tend to ship in the most sustainable way when compared to other couriers. And it's a small step. You don't have to do it, but I wanted to do it. That's why I took that particular step. Also, my particular business is ethical because I involve all this aspect, and I'm supporting a cause that is basically feeding the community dogs and helping the strays. So that was the main cause as to why I started this sustainable business. So this is just a picture of products that I use. Like you can see, the gum tape is also made from paper. I use newspapers or brown papers which don't have a plastic lining for packaging. I write my own thank you cards, so I you know, don't go to print anything. I make my own tags, you can see in the center, without, with leftover papers. I also have a visiting card which is made from seed paper. So basically seed paper, a card is based, are those visiting cards that you are done using, or if a person doesn't want that, to keep that particular visiting card, he just has to tear it and throw it into the mud. A beautiful plant is going to grow out of it. These are the small steps we all can take whenever we can effort to make, you know, our living sustainable. So these are some of the products that I make. The first one is a scrap fabric. Then I have made, you know, a scrap thread planter. I make bags out of cotton cords. I make coasters. I'm not going to go into detail, but I want to show you one particular product right there on the top. This is a plastic. You would have seen this particular tags that comes with the, you know, boxes. They use this for packaging, the white one at the top. So I use that. I had seen you know, a particular shop near my house throw this particular tags from the products they had got. So I collected all of them and I made a basket out of it, which I used to store my you know, cotton cords. So that's how you can lead a sustainable life, you guys. You don't have to make a big change. It is about the small steps. Even a small recycling thing that you do, using a Bisleri bottle as a hanger, plant hanger, instead of throwing it into the dustbin, is a sustainable choice. So you have it in you to make these sustainable choices. Also, when you're speaking about sustainability, it matters a lot. You have to see about the ethics the company holds, their core value, about how they are marketing the products. It is very necessary to do a background check of the particular brand, about, you know, how their principles are when it comes to environmental issues, fair trade, as I said, which is ethical fair trade, regarding animal exploitation. Also humanitarian issues like racism or gender inequality, or how they treat the underprivileged class of the society. You can do a background check of this. There is certain app called Be Good On You, that's Good On You, which speaks a lot about various brands like Nike, Adidas, Zara, H&M, you know, most of the brands, they speak about how ethical these brands are and how you know, these brands are striving, if they are striving to make, you know, sustainable options. Also, there are certain apps that helps you understand better which ingredients are vegan. So there is vegan additives and food additives, which I use left, right and center whenever I buy something, just to see whether these ingredients are vegan, because many have chemical names and numbers which you really don't understand. So like ESI, etc. So you can just enter the numbers in this particular app and then they'll give you a, you know, an insight to that particular ingredient as to whether it is vegan, whether it's animal derived, or whether it can be both vegan and as well as animal derived. So you can use this particular app to find out. So that's it about sustainable living. I hope you all understand. So what I would like to stress at the end is that it is not about being perfect. It's not about one person striving towards sustainability. It is about millions of us, millions of people trying to change, even if it's a small step, even if it's a larger step, doing our best to our best of ability in such a way that we can show to people, set an example that we care. We do care about, not only about ourselves, we do care about others, we do care about the earth, we do care about everything this earth has to offer us. So you can be the best, be the perfect, or you can be, you know, imperfect and still be perfect by making certain small changes. I hope you all found this useful. So as I always say, stay kind, stay compassionate, and I stick to the motto called Vasudeva Kutumbakam, that is, this world is one family. So yeah, thank you so much. Over to you, Meghana.
Yeah, if anyone has any queries, please do ask. Shruti, you can also see the comments. And there's a question on suggesting vegan hair dyes.
Okay. There is a particular influencer. Her name is Lavanya Sharma. You can follow her on Instagram. So she is into this particular hair dyes. I mean, she's a vegan and she knows a lot about it. Maybe that would be great help, you know, of you. I can type it here, her, you know, Instagram handle, so that you can check that out. There's also a brand called as Rado. You can check that out as well, which also makes, you know, vegan hair dyes. Yes. Can you name some sustainable clothing brands for men as well as women? Yes. Another thing, instead of naming brands, I will give you a name on influencer who are into promoting this. Follow Ananya Gupta as well as Ulisu by Mridula. Do you want me to type the names so that it will be easy for you all? So Ulisu by Mridula and Ananya Gupta, they have their, Ulisu by Mridula, she has a website of her own where she has listed every damn sustainable options available on this, you know, in and around India, from package free to clothes to products, everything. So please do check her out website, because instead of me telling about one brand, I know a few brands, but they can turn out expensive. For some, instead of that, you know, if you go check that out, you will get variety of options, because she has a particular category called as sustainable clothing items. Ananya Gupta, she's an influencer. She also has a lot of, you know, she supports a lot of sustainable clothing lines. You can check that out too.
Shruti, we have one more query. That is, what is a sustainable razor?
Okay, so basically, we all use razors that come with plastic handles, right? So there are razors that come with reusable handles, but you can change the head. This head are again made out of plastic, or the cream or that inbuilt lotion that comes with it usually has beeswax in it, or sodium laureate or tallowate in it, which are again not vegan. So a sustainable razor is basically the handle is either made out of stainless steel or it is made out of wood. Basically bamboo, and the razor head is completely rust-free stainless steel. Okay, you just have to change the blade. The blade is again a metal, so it is sustainable because you can recycle that particular metal. You can give it to Kabadiwalas, the razors, and they are going to resell it for recycling. So that is sustainable razor. If you want the company name, as of now in India, Womanhood, as well as Soapworks or Earth Rhythms make sustainable razors.
And what are sustainable, which are sustainable light bulbs?
Sustainable light bulbs. Yes.
Yes.
Again, when it comes to that, you know, fluorescent bulbs, then switching to LEDs, you know, CFL bulbs, those are more better. Another thing, when it comes to light, I wanted to say solar. If you have the options of using solar, if you are from a place where, like in Mangalore, we don't have any other season. It's either raining with sun or only sun. So, you know, what do you call solar panels are great. So if you can invest on that, please, please, please invest on solar panels. Most of the time it works, even in places where, you know, it, they don't see sun that, I mean, throughout the day when the sunlight is not there, also solar panels do work. I know of many places. So solar panels, if you can invest on it, solar lights, it's best.
Okay. Okay. Thank you so much, Shruti. So we will be winding up the session. It was extremely, extremely insightful. I personally learned a lot, and I'm sure everyone here. And I personally thank you, and I thank on behalf of Fiapo for taking out time and giving this wonderful energetic session. I thank everyone for being here and listening to the session. Please do sign up to our newsletters for and so that you do not miss our any future sessions. Do support local business. Shruti also has one, Soulfully Made Crafts, and a couple of people also shared in the comments. Just be vocal for local. With that note, I'll be ending the session. Thank you all again. Have a great weekend.
Thank you.